Konate is the problem. Dribble everyone, do him like a Messi. Tamam, tamam. Teşekkürler.
Teşekkürler.
Afiyet olsun.
Mami, öncelikle hoş geldin programımıza. Türkiye'ye nasıl transfer oldun? Oradan başlayalım istersen. Gelmeden önce Hatay hakkında neler biliyordun? Daha önce Türkiye'de oynayan futbolculardan bilgi aldın mı?
Yeah, I got some information from Badu, and since we've been to stuck together, so I've been asking him a lot of question about Turkey and everything about the football and stuff. But about Hatay, I didn't know about it, to be honest. But first time they told me about it, I was like, okay, let me check it out. So I check it on Google, you know, like everybody, check around and stuff, and see they just promoted, they have new coach and new stuff. So I was like, okay, let me go and check it out. And when I get to the city and talk to everybody, the staff and everything, you know, the things was right. You know, like sometimes you just go somewhere and you just feel like, okay, this can be something. So, and we were coming in the, then they just got promoted. It's a big challenge. So for me, and I like challenge. I like doing things that, you know, just going and saying, you know what, I can do it. So that's why I say, okay, you know what, I'm just going to go there, try to help the team. It's a new project, and it's new players, and everybody's coming like together to build something.
This is the first time in Super League for Hatay Spor. Yeah. Although the authorities don't give a chance at the beginning of the season, but you guys reaching a good result and playing a very good game, and every day your team improved itself. What would you like to say, and what is the secret of Hatay Spor?
I don't think we have a lot of secret, but the only thing I can say is we have good staff. We have good coach that understand the game, that always be there behind his players, you know, trying to push them. And we're just learning. We know it's a new thing, and it's a new challenge for, like, everybody in the team. Because last year they were in the second league, and now they promoted. So everybody is like, this is a big thing. And we're taking it and doing it together as a team, listening to whatever the coach tell us and how he want to play. And we had a lot of transfers. And in all that, it's always hard to build up a team. But thanks God, we understand that early in the beginning and playing together as a team. And I hope we'll continue to do that.
Ömer Erdoğan ve ekibi hakkında neler düşünüyorsun? Yükselen bir teknik direktör, oyuncularla ilişkisi nasıl? Onu nasıl tanımlarsın?
We have a good relationship, a great one, I can say, because he always trying to talk to the player, you know, be there, you know, just to understand what they really think, because he know it's a new thing for all of us, and it's a new challenge for all of us, and he have a great vision. You know, you can see it on the games. We're improving day by day. Every weekend, we're improving. And it's just showing us how he really know about football. And he played it as a professional, and now he's doing it as a coach. So I think if we listen to him, we'll go more further.
Hatay Spor is a new team. What can you say about the main goal?
I don't think we have a main goal, but of course we have a main goal, but you know, it's not some stuff you say. You always have to prove it in the pitch, and that's what we try to do every weekend, you know, trying to prove ourselves, you know, taking game by game. And I know if we don't rush stuff or thinking too much, if we just let everything go and play our football and week by week. So hopefully if we keep winning, we never know, the sky is the limit. So we're just going to keep playing day by day, weekend by weekend, and we'll see where it's going to take us at the end of the season.
Futbol dışında neler yapmayı seviyor? Vakit bulabiliyor mu çalışmaktan?
I don't think I do a lot because of the corona stuff. It's not a lot of things to do at the moment, but I'm trying to occupy myself, like finish training, go to the mall, or just go outside and just keep walking. I love to just go in the city and just drive to the mall, park my car, get out and just walk.
What will you do after quitting from the football? Do you have any plans?
I'll sleep, take care of my family. No, at the moment, I don't know. I'm not looking forward to that thing. So at the moment, I'm enjoying playing football, so I'm focused on that. And we'll see after.
Kendine bir özellik eklemek istesen hangi yeteneğini güçlendirmek istersin? Gerçi gayet güçlü bir insansın ama.
Let's say trying to dribble everyone, doing like a Messi. Maybe try to do it like Messi, but you know, skill is part of football, but more important is what's important is the team. So always try to be effective in the game. So that's always what I try to do.
Before Hatayspor, have you ever got offer from Turkey?
Yeah, a lot.
Names
a lot, yeah.
Name of the teams, maybe?
Nah, it's been a lot of team. Let's leave it there. Now I'm in Hatay, so the most important thing is just Hatay.
Maybe from Istanbul, right?
You know. Okay.
Hakemlerle alakalı ne söylemek istiyor? Türkiye'de çok konuşuluyor. Dünyanın iki önemli liginde futbol oynadı. Bu kadar ön planda mıydı orada hakemler?
Yeah, but in every football game, you see, it's always the referee will always be the attention because it's just one man trying to decide for what. If you go with you, you're happy about it. If you go against you, you're not happy about it. But you know, referee are just human beings. For me, I'm not gonna try to judge them. I know they're doing their best, trying to do their best to make everyone happy. But you know. It's a hard job because you can't make everybody happy and people will always talk because it's the game of football. No matter which, even VAR, people complain about VAR. Even though VAR will give you something, they will still complain. So that's the nature of the game.
Is there any specific memory that you can't forget about your days at Manchester United?
I think that's going to be my first day there. So just to come in the dressing room and see people coming in one by one, and I know all of them. I was just watching them the last Sunday playing football, so for me to just to be in the dressing room with them was like, wow, okay, am I really here? Am I really seeing Rooney, Scholes, Berbatov, Giggs? I was like, wow. But you know, they helped me a lot to grow, and that's what I like about that team. So when you come there, they always give you that opportunity to grow, to get a lot of experience in football, and it was a great experience for me. I was in shock, and I was young at that age. It was just like, wow, really? Every Sunday I'm sitting here watching the game, now I'm going to go and join them. It was unbelievable feeling, but, you know, like I said, I worked hard for that. And that happened, and it was a great experience for me.
Alex Ferguson'la çalışma fırsatı buldu. Onunla alakalı düşünceleri neler?
Wow, the guy is a legend. He's a legend. He's a godfather of football. So it's a lot of things. He know and understand player, and on top of that, the human being. So it's like he know them right word to say to you that giving you motivation to just keep going. So I thanks God I was part of that, and I thanks God I can say, oh, he was my coach before, and I'm really grateful to just knowing him, saying hi to you is a wonderful thing.
Last time in Champions League, when Başakşehir played with Paris Saint-Germain, they had an awful racist situation. Has something like this happened to you before? And what can you say about Dembaba and other players' attitude? They stand against racism. What can you say about it?
Yo, it's just a crazy thing. And them type of thing, we won't allow it in this sport we all love. Because football should unite everybody. It's no color in football. It's no color in human. We all human beings. You know, God created us like this. We all human beings. Nobody is more perfect than anybody. But, you know, some people, of course, it's life. Sometimes you see some crazy things happen. But we're not going to let that small things just divide us. We all have to think and go all together strongly. And like what Dembaba did, you know what? When I saw that, I was just like, wow, this is the type of things we need to show to people, to show them we all the same, we all human beings. So we just have to live on. And I never been in this type of situation. Even though if I was on it, I will just keep going and knowing, you know what, some people have other opinion. That one you can't take away with it. But we'll fight together. When we united, we're stronger. So we just have to do that. Keep going on that way, and don't let them type of small things that just divide us.
Ömer Hoca analize önem veren bir hoca. Bunu baktığımız zaman her maçta görüyoruz. Belli başlı organizasyonlara karşı önlemler alıyorlar. O maç öncesi hazırlık sürecinden biraz bahsedebilir mi?
Yeah, but that's what great coach do. That's what good coach do. That's just show you he have a great vision about football. And we have a great analyzed team. Every game is they always ready for, you know, giving you all the action of everything. So every time we have a game, before the game, we always have the video that telling us our opponent, what's their strong side and what's their weak side and all that stuff. So they're all making sure we always get them information before the game. So I think
en beğendiği yemek, Hatay'ın inanılmaz bir mutfağı var.
The fish. I eat fish, so I really enjoy the fish. The food is great here, and I'm just trying not to think about the food too much because I don't want to be too heavy on the pitch. So I have to take it easy. Sometimes I see a lot of good food and I say to myself, it's really good, but don't touch it. You know, just trying to stay healthy a little bit. But the food here is wonderful.
Have you tried künefe?
That's the problem. Künefe is the problem. It's too good and it's really crazy. So I'm just trying to stay away, running away from it. But it's really good.
Takımda en iyi anlaştığı oyuncular kimler?
What, in the team?
Yes, in the team.
I get along with everybody. I'm the type of player that just I talk only rubbish. So when I'm in there, I just say whatever I feel and, you know, just trying to bring the atmosphere, you know, more joyful, you know, like when you're in the training ground, I don't like to come and see everybody so serious because, you know, you need to mix it up.
It is the beginning. What was the hardest game for this season?
I think I would say the game we lost 6-0 in Alanya. I think that game was really heartbreaking, but, you know, in that moment it was really tough to just...
Kariyerinin en iyi maçı Brann'a 4 gol atmıştı mesela. O mu?
Nah, it was one of them. But I will go with the game I play City against Stoke because we beat them in their stadium and it was the first game that Stoke ever win against City away. So it was only one goal and I scored it. So it was the perfect thing. But the Brann game, that one is part of it too.
Birçok statta maç oynadı. City'ye karşı, işte İngiltere'de Arsenal'a karşı, Chelsea'ye karşı. En etkilendiği stat hangisi?
I will say Liverpool.
Liverpool. Yeah.
that stadium was something. Just to, because you're always gonna feel the fans. You know what I mean? Like as before the game start, it's just amazing.
Yeah, you played against very strong teams in the Premier League and scored goals. The most challenging defensive player?
I will go Kompany.
Kompany.
Vincent Kompany.
Kompany.
Yeah. He is too strong, Mike. He is too big. So, yeah, I will go in.
Senegal milli takımında da 50'nin üzerinde maça çıktı. En iyi anlaştığı isim kimdi?
We know you all get along with the everybody, man.
Yeah.
Probably one best friend.
No, but you know, it's always an honor to play to defend your country. So just to be part of the 23 player they call is always an honor. And we in Senegal, you know, like in Africa, we have thousands of players that can play in any position. So just to be part of that, it was a great experience. And in Senegalese national team is. I've been there for 10 years or more. So I get along with everybody. And my room was the room that everybody comes. So I don't know. It's always hard to say.
Son soruyu soracağım. Hatay Spor taraftarıyla bu koronavirüs nedeniyle, pandemi nedeniyle tanışma fırsatı bulamadı. Tribünlerde olamadı. Hatay halkının ona dışarıya çıktığında yaklaşımı nasıl? Onunla alakalı neler söylemek ister? Son olarak onlara ne mesaj göndermek ister Hatay Spor taraftarına?
Like you know, it's always hard to play football without fun because football should be a sport that enjoy everybody and bring everyone together. But we know at the moment, unfortunately, it's really hard because of Corona, and you know, we always have to stay safe. It's a hard thing to do, but you know, we're dealing with it, and I'm just excited to see them, to see their reaction. So sometimes when I go outside and I see them, they're all happy, and they see the team is improving, and it's a lot of new player, and it's a thing that everybody waiting for, and the excitement is there. And you receive texts, like thousands of texts from the fans and all that. I know they all miss the team. They all miss to see us. But hopefully soon everything will be gone and we'll forget about everything and just enjoy the game of football we all love. And the best thing is if you do it with the fans, it will be unbelievable.
Mame, thank you very much.
Teşekkürler.
Biz teşekkür ederiz abi.
Güzel kapanış oldu. Hatay Spor'un Senegal milli takımında da forma giyen golcü futbolcusunu konuk ettik. Bu sezona fırtına gibi başladı. Ankara Gücü maçında da başarılar diliyoruz sana. Röportajı kabul ettiğin için de çok teşekkür ediyoruz sana.
No problem guys. Thank you so much for having me. I really enjoy talking to you guys. And I hope next time I will speak Turkish instead of you translating. I will say tamam.
Teşekkürler.
Afiyet olsun.
Oh, good.
Teşekkürler. You already know a lot.
Oh, yeah. I have to. Güle güle. No problem.